story, one story, and the title is here. The jackdaw and the jackdaw. Okay. So, have you ever seen this story or heard this story?
No.
So now let me tell you. So this is. There are three characters in my story. One is the rain, and here the highest one here is the apple, and this one here, a small one on the rain flag. Here is the jackdaw. So one. So there was an eagle, and the eagle is a very big bird, right? And he can touch. It can touch the animal, like some sheep or some. Lamb, yes, like kind of it is the kind of big animal, and then he can fly faster. So at the time, the eagle catch the rain, not the rain, the lamb. So he can catch the lamb, and then he bring it to his net, to his net. So at the time, he can fly faster and catch the rain with his talon. So that's at the time. The jackdaw saw that one, saw that situation, and then the jackdaw want to do like the animal. It want to catch animal and fly up, fly like the animal. So he tried to do the same as the animal. So he can fly. He want to fly. He start flying. But when the heavy air is coming, he came down slowly. But he came down on the ram's back. So you know the rams, it have a lot of feather, right? A very, very, how can you say that? Yeah. And then when he came down, and then he stay on the back of the ram. At the time he fall down, he tried to sit there. Oh, he want to fly again. So he start flying again, but he cannot go. It cannot move from the back of the ram. He still stay because of he tangled his leg is black tangled with the feather of the ram, and then he cannot fly anymore. He cannot move away from the back of the ram, and the ram doesn't know because of his feather, and he cannot know. He walk away. So in the evening coming, the can say the shepherd come, and then he saw the jackdaw. He saw the jackdaw. He think that, oh, maybe what happened with the jackdaw. So he running quickly. He runs quickly and catch the jackdaw and cut his wing. Take it out and cut his wing, and then it cannot fly. The jackdaw cannot fly anymore. And then he bring that jackdaw to home and gave it to his children, and his children asked that what animal of it, what kind of it, and then his father said that the shepherd said that it's called jackdaw. But when his child saw that animal, he laughed. And then his father continued, he said that, but if you refer to yourself, his son, if you ask him himself as the jackdaw itself, it will say that he is the eagle, because you ever heard it, the jackdaw wants to become the eagle. When you ask him, you ask it, it will say that it is an eagle, not a jackdaw. So this one is, that's all for my story. And can you guess what is it of the meaning of the proverb? The jackdaw really, really want to do like the eagle, but it cannot. It is a small one. It cannot fly up her, and he cannot catch the animal like that with flying. So, but if you ask it, it will say that it is an eagle and a powerful animal, powerful bird like that. So what is it? So, and the proverb is, do not let your vanity make you overestimate your power. Overestimate means that you can count it too. You can count like that. Almost overestimate me like that. So don't let your vanity make you overestimate your power. Understand this one? It's simple, like I saw a person. He has a car, one man, he has a one woman the same as me. And also the same age. And then she have a very, very nice car. So I really want to buy a car like her, but I don't have enough money. And I try to borrow from someone to buy that car to her. I'm very, very poor, so it means like that. That is a proverb. So for me, I think maybe không khởi động đấy chứ không chúng ta trong chúng ta không phải như vậy. Just my idea, but I don't know is it right or wrong. Okay, so that's all. This is my story. Thank you for your listening.